Hard work can beat talent. Hi, this is Kalpana Reddy from Krishi High School. Today, I am here to discuss about class 7, chapter 7, that is of Africa. So in the previous, session, children, we have learned about Europe, isn't it? So in this session, we are going to learn about Africa. So you know na Africa, isn't it? So yes. So I have the slide to show the political map of it, children. Just be with me. Are you able to see? Yes. So here, are you able to see, children? This is the political map of Africa. You can see here, isn't it, children? Yes. So this is the political map of Africa. So you know that Africa is one of the continent, isn't it? There are 7 continents, isn't it? So out of that, Africa is one of the continent. And if I say that it's a second largest continent, do you know that it is the second largest continent? So Africa is the second largest continent. And total how many countries are there in this continent? There are 54 countries. There are 54 countries. That means it's a highly populated country. Is that clear to you? It's a highly populated country. So Africa is the second largest continent with 54 countries. And do you know that it is also known as with some other name? What is that? Yeah, I'll tell you. It is also called as dark continent. It is also called as dark continent. Now, now here is a work for you, children. You should find out why Africa is called a dark continent. So you should find out why Africa is called as dark continent, and this will be for your homework. It's a small activity, so just find out that why Africa is called as a dark continent. Okay, children, and you have to post it. Just write on a piece of paper and post it, children. Okay. And if we talk about the boundaries, of the Africa, here on the north, you can see the Mediterranean Sea. On the north, you can see the Mediterranean Sea. And if we talk about the northeast, so you can find the Red Sea and Swiss Canal. And if we talk about the west, we will find Atlantic Ocean, and in the southwest we have Indian Ocean. So these are the boundaries of Africa. Okay. And Algeria, it's a country in Africa. Algeria is the most largest populated country in Africa. Africa. And you know that you might have heard also in the in the previous classes also, in your lower class also, Mount Kilimanjaro is the highest peak of Africa, isn't it? It's the highest peak of Africa. So you might have heard one song also in Rajnikanth movie or somewhere, Kilimanjaro, Kilimanjaro. In that they will show that peak, isn't it? So it's the highest peak of Africa. And we have a longest river also, which is located in Africa, children. That is Nile. And the longest river of world, that is Nile, is located, flows in Africa only. Is that clear to you, children? So the Mount Kilimanjaro is the highest peak of Africa, and the longest river of world as well as Africa is Nile River, children. And if we talk about the desert, so this area is also covered with desert land. Okay. So the Sahara Desert is the largest desert. Okay. This Sahara Desert is the largest desert of Africa, children. And do you know that? So do you think that if it is a desert area, so there will be no source of resources of water? No, it's not like that. There is a river which flows through this desert area, Sahara Desert, which is called as River Nile Go. Okay, children, and it's a surprising to say that this river Nile Go is, or this Nile River is origin of Lake Victoria. It's a origin from Lake Victoria, children. Okay, and this Nile River, it flows through the Egypt. It flows through the Egypt and it supports their civilization. And it supports their civilization. That means what? It gives the water sources to them. It's a water source for the Egypt people. Okay, children. Is that clear to you? So I have few more slides to share with you, children. Yeah, so this we have like already seen. One second. Yeah. So as I said, Africa, the large continent, lies to the west of India. In this country, there are extensively desert, dense forest, long and broad river, large lakes and grasslands stretching over thousands of miles. Isn't it, children? The world's largest gold and diamond mines are also located here. So apart from this all, the world largest gold and diamond mines, you know, mines means what? Those are located in Africa only. Human beings first evolved in Africa and moved to the other countries. So the early man, okay. So you might have learned in class 6 also about the early man. See, they first evolved in Africa and then they moved to some other continents. Is that clear to you? So here I've already shared the image of the political map, children. Here again you can see. So this is the Sahara Desert. Okay, this is the Sahara Desert, and these are the, like I can say, the forest area. Yes. Yeah. So this is the city. I said now already, the Algeria is the highly populated country of African continent. Africa, the large continent, lies to the west of India. In this continent, there are extremely desert and dense forests. So already this one covered, children. So Africa, a vast plateau. So it's a plateau region. It's a plateau region, a narrow plain on the coast, and rest of the continent is a vast plateau. So maximum part of the Africa is covered with plateau region, and we will find several mountains on this plateau region. The highest peak, as I've already discussed, is Mount Kilimanjaro, and which is located in Tanzania, In the north, there is a Sahara Desert, and in the south, there is a Kalahari Desert. So we have two deserts. One is Sahara Desert in the north and the Kalahari Desert in the south. Yes, you can see. Yes, this is the peak, children. Okay, the river. Yeah, this is the Sahara Desert. This light already covered. Yeah. Africa, a vast plateau. Most part of the Egypt is in Sahara Desert and it receives very scanty rainfall. The Nile River flows across the Sahara Desert through Egypt. This longest river helped for Egyptian civilization. So already I have explained you, isn't it? So most part of the Egypt is in Sahara Desert and it receives. So desert means it receives a scanty rainfall only. So from where they are getting the water as a source, it's a Nile River only. Nile River is only, like, I mean, it's a source of water for them. Is that clear to you, children? So the Nile River flows across the Sahara Desert through Egypt. Okay. So the longest river helped for Egyptian civilization. The water of the Nile helped to irrigate the fields of Egypt for thousands of years. So this river Nile is like helping the Egyptian civilization or the Egyptians to grow their crops or to irrigate the crops and to fulfill their requirement or a requirement of water. Okay, children. And Lake Victoria is the largest freshwater lake on this plateau. And Lake Victoria is the largest fresh lake, water lake on this plateau. Okay. Yeah. So with this, I have just finished the basic introduction of the lesson, children. So in the next session, we will go deep into the chapter. Okay, children, and I just wanted to discuss that like few of them, what they are doing, they are uploading the homework in WhatsApp as well as in the Google Classroom, children. So please don't do that. If you have the access of Google Classroom, kindly post the homeworks in Google Classroom only. Again, don't use both the options, children. You have to either use Google Classroom or WhatsApp. If you have the access with the Google Classroom, just go with that, children. Again, don't post in WhatsApp, children. Is that clear to you, children? So with this, I'm just going to wind up the class. So it's a small session only because I've just touched the introduction, children. We'll go deep into the lesson tomorrow, the next session, right, children? And the activity what I have given, that you have to find out is why the river, like I mean, say African continent is also called as dark continent. So that activity, so you have to find out the reason, put it on a paper and just submit in Google Classroom, children. Okay, and top of it, you have to read the lesson also, whatever the topics I have covered, right, children? So with this, I'm just going to wind up the class. Thank you for being connected with me. Bye-bye. Take care.